Another video for linmop.net. What I'm going to do here today is to show you what I've done with Firefox on my Arch Linux ARM install. Actually, this is something that's not really complicated, and you all could do that too, because, well, yeah, I think it's rather easy, but it's not that well known, so I figured I could show it. Firefox, as you may know, supports multiple profiles, and that can be quite handy. So, to see whether your Firefox already uses multiple profiles on your PinePhone or also your desktop Linux box, right? You could use multiple profiles there too. You go to About, colon, I hope that's even correct, and yeah, and then profiles, and then you see all the profiles you have here. Now I've got three profiles here that are aptly named. So Firefox, which is the default profile that comes with the distribution. Tor, which is for browsing with Tor, so it has a Tor proxy configured. And a third one that is called SSB for site-specific browsers. So why would I do these different profiles? Well, there are multiple reasons. Like, if you want to have a different set of plugins enabled in different instances of Firefox, this is a good way to do it. So as you can see here in my default profile, I just have uBlock Origin active. Now, if I close this Firefox and go to my Torfox, which has an icon that is apparently related to security, it's one of those stock GNOME icons. It not only starts with a different start page, which is check.torproject.org, but as you can see, it has NoScript enabled. Now, NoScript is something that you want to use with Tor in order to be more secure. By the way, we can double check that this is really Tor enabled by opening Google, and we should see those annoying. Oh, what's wrong there? Why doesn't it force me to go to 15 captures? Yeah, got lucky there. How do you set this up? So I just installed Tor, and I think it's Tor socks. For the socks proxy part here on Arch Linux ARM, and then went into these preferences, which work somewhat okay if you adjust the scaling or scaling. So, and then you go to network settings here, and yeah, here you can see it. So I now it's really small and barely visible. Maybe I can choose something in between. No, I can't. So settings, and then here the last line, soxhost localhost port 9050, which is the port of Tor Sox on Arch Linux ARM at least. And yeah, that's how that worked. Now I should also hit this one, proxy DNS when using SOX v5, because that's something we should do for extra security, which I apparently hadn't set up before. But well, yeah, see, that was a full video. But yeah, again, if you don't you do this on platforms where you can easily get a proper Tor browser, but if you can't, this is a okay way to use Tor without having to use Tor all the time. I mean, you can use, and maybe depending on your needs, should use Tor all the time. But I understand if you don't, because I don't either, because it's just too stressful to have all those stupid captures all the time. So that's one thing you can do with profiles. You can use a different set of plugins. And you can easily configure proxies and so on. You can do even more. So if we go to about-config, you are going to see that I changed the user agent here. Because by default, this package, so this is the user agent here. It's fairly small. The general user agent override. So by default, the browser says it would be Android and so on, and that means that you get those app recommendation on many pages that you should install that stupid app. And if you set it like this, you don't get those. So that's something I did here for the Tor profile. I don't think I changed it for my default profile. Let's just check. So again, about colon config. And again, proceed with caution. Yeah, sure. Always. Yeah, that is what is apparently the current default wire Firefox dash mobile dash config. And that's Android 6.0 mobile, blah, blah, blah. And that causes you to get that stupid, those stupid banners all the time. Hey, use our stupid Android app, which you can do on the Pinephone with Nbox, which I don't have installed here. So if I go to element, so app.element.io for metrics, in this browser, with the almost close to default settings, I get this stupid screen. So set up element on iOS or Android, blah, 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 install the app, and so on. And then you would have to tap this here, go to desktop site. So on my element SSB site specific browser, it also loads app.element.io. See if hydrogen loads. Yeah, hydrogen seems to load just fine. Okay, so this is the mobile version, which is what I usually use when I just want to browse what's going on in metrics sets. And of course, this here supports encryption, so I could go into any of my encrypted conversations or just in all those chat rooms I'm in, right? Quite a lot. This here is how that screen looks when you go to About Profiles. And then you tap Create a New Profile. This wizard pops up that explains you what Firefox profiles are about. And then you set a name. And I recommend you to choose a folder, because otherwise it will choose something random like it did here. But let's choose it like this for now, because that's what I did with the profile. And then got this new profile and hit finish, and now I've got this new profile. I would of course want to launch that specific new profile, and that can be done via the terminal. I mean, there's another way, but I'll just show it like that because that can be handy later. And then you've got to add the whole path, so home mobn.mozilla-firefox-ssb-default. Now it should be launching, unless I made a stupid typo or something. Yeah. Now there seems to be no difference. We can now check whether it's the right profile with about profiles again, and now says, hey, this is the profile in use and cannot be deleted. So that worked fine. Now we're going to about colon config, and in here is one setting we need to enable if we actually want to use the browser as a SSB. So now this SSB feature that makes it so that you've got basically just the browser without an address bar, so that it's site specific, right? Makes that feature work. You need to manually enable those. Now, SSB is one feature we want to enable, but there are other properties that we can change, because normally on this Firefox mobile config enabled Firefox, let me go to app.element.io, because after all, that's where we want to go here. And if we do that, to get proper element on the PinePhone, we get this page, because the user agent has a default override. So it's saying, hey, this is Android 9 mobile. At least the version is correct here. But this Android 9 in there makes it so that we get this message. It's telling us, oh, and then we have to go down there to go to desktop site. Now, that's of course something that's quite annoying, and we can change this custom user agent. It's a bit tedious maybe, but let's just delete that Android thing and keep mobile, which is that mobile flag was used on Firefox OS back in the day. And now if you reload this here, we don't see any change yet, but now if we remove that mobile guide and go back to the default URL, just app.element.io should now load something different. Yeah, and that is element, we can just sign in. So that's something that's really something that's very handy for SSBs. But at least I could show that Hydrogen worked and Tor browser worked. So I think that's something. It worked for me for all this week. So Firefox profiles are nice, and you can do a lot with them. Try them out on your phone or desktop and have fun with them. Thanks for watching, and see you soon.